Hello friends, welcome to GYES. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, currently we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains, and also we have one dedicated test series that is for your that covers your current affairs. So in this video we will be talking about our 12 mains and prelims series. So what we have done, basically we have divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics, and we daily cover your two subtopics, and in this manner in 6 days we cover all your 12 subtopics, and this process goes on and on in a cyclic manner, and we will continue to do so till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So let's start our discussion. So the first question is Mahatma. Today the lecture is about the modern India, lecture number 22. So let's see what is the first question. First question is Mahatma Gandhi was opposed to separate electorates for untouchables for which of the following reasons? First, the system did not allow other communities to get reserved seats in legislatures. Second, a leader could get elected only once on a separate electorate ticket. So we have to choose the correct statement. That we, which of the above statements is correct? Let me tell you friends that none of these statements is correct, because basically Mahatma Gandhi was opposed to separate electorates for Dalits because he saw that British are trying to create a divide between Hindus themselves, between the Harijans and the other castes, as they have divided the Hindus and Muslims by the separate electorates of 1909. So that's why Mahatma Gandhi was opposed to separate electorates, and the answer would be D, that is none. So the solution is D. So here is the explanation. So you can see the explanation that basically Gandhi opposed the proposal because it would divide the Hindus as well as the Harijans. So British saw another opportunity to divide Indians on these lines and to further their kind of empire in India. So in 1909 the British had introduced separate electorates for Hindus and Muslims, which had adversely affected the unity among the Hindus and Muslims. So that's why Mahatma Gandhi was opposed to separate electorates for the Dalits also. So the answer would be D, that none of these statements is correct explanation of the reason why the Mahatma Gandhi opposed the separate electorates for Dalits. Let's move on to the second question. The second question is, which of the following developments of 1860s have a boost to the Indian industries? First, policy of discriminating protection as formally adopted by the British. Second, American Civil War. Third, progressive ruralization movement. So we have to choose the correct answer. And let me tell you friends that in India in 1860s the industry received major boost. So the main reason for this is the American Civil War, because at that time the American Civil War was there. So the raw cotton, which was earlier exported by the America, now it was no longer exported to the Britain. So the Britain needed the raw cotton and they turned towards India. So second is the major reason. First and three has no relation with the industrialization boost. So the answer would be second only. So the B would be the answer. So solution is B. So here in this question we will provide only the answer only, because we have provided the explanation of the first question so that you can see the quality of our explanations. So in case you want to subscribe to the explanation PDFs of all the questions, then you can email us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at this number, that is 8968426481. So this is our number. In case you want to get the explanation PDF of all MCQs, you can contact us on our email ID or on our number. So obviously there will be a minimum cost for it, but it is kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability as well as for the purpose of our motivation. So let's move on to the third question. The third question is, the Gandhi-Irwin Pact included which of the following commitments by both the parties? First, civil disobedience movement will be called off. Second, British would reduce land rent by half in areas of Mahalwadi settlements. Third, income and corporation taxes would be reduced. Fourth, military expenditure on foreign lands would not be financed from Indian exchequer. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you friends that the Gandhi-Irwin Pact was related only to the first statement, that is the Congress on its part agreed to withdraw the civil disobedience and also agreed to participate in the round table conference, that is second round table conference, which was to take place in Britain. So the answer is one only. So the solution would be A. Other statements are not correct. So the answer is A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, the Dandi March was launched against first, state monopoly on manufacture and sale of salt; second, exorbitantly high salt tax. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. And let me tell you, friend, that Dandi March was basically launched for both of these reasons, because at that time the state it was the monopoly of the government to manufacture the salt, and salt was not just manufactured, it was also taxed. So a tax of that was in effect. Sometimes it would go the 14 times the cost of production. So the tax was very high. So this for both were the reasons for the launch of Dandi March. So the answer is C, both 1 and 2. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, the Lahore session of Indian National Congress was significant for which of the following reasons? So here we have been asked that why the Lahore session was important. So first, election of Gandhi as INC president; second, proclamation of commitment to Purna Swaraj. So we have to choose the correct statement, and let me tell you, friends, that first is not correct, because in actual practice, in Lahore session, the person who was elected president was Jawaharlal Nehru and not Gandhi. But in fact, it was important in the sense that the Congress demanded the Purna Swaraj, that is complete independence from the British rule, for the first time. So the answer would be second only. So the B is the answer. So solution is B. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, Gandhi listed 7 rules as essential for every satyagrahi in India. These rules included that the satyagrahi must. So there were 7 rules that Gandhi propounded about a person that want to become a satyagrahi, that he had to follow these 7 rules. So out of these, we have to choose those which were part of these rules. So first is having living faith in God; second, have faith in the inherent goodness of human nature; third, be a habitual khadi wearer and spinner. So we have to choose the correct statement, and let me tell you, all of these statements are correct. So the answer would be D, that is 1, 2, and 3. There were other rules also that are that were essential for every satyagrahi, but they are mentioned in our explanation PDF. So the solution is D. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, 7th, consider the following about the Khilafat movement. First, it was initiated by Maulana Abul Kalam Azad; second, it demanded that Khalifa must retain control over the Muslim sacred places in the erstwhile Ottoman Empire; third, the Congress boycotted the movement due to its violent moorings. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you, friends, that the answer is second. That is, it was the Khilafat movement demanded that Khalifa must retain control over the Muslim sacred places in the erstwhile Ottoman Empire. So movement was not initiated by Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. It was initiated by Shaukat Ali and Maulana Ali, that is Ali brothers. And Congress was in fact support of this movement. And Gandhi tried to Gandhi saw this as an opportunity to bring Muslims together, and Muslims and Hindus together on the same cause. So the answer would be second only. So the solution is C. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following statements. First, Gandhiji spent a year traveling around British India on Gokhale's advice; second, Gandhiji first forged the techniques of non-violent satyagraha in South Africa. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you, friends, that both of these statements are correct. Gandhiji spent a year traveling around British India, and also he forged the techniques of non-violent satyagraha in South Africa. So the answer would be C, that is both 1 and 2. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is 9th question. 9th question is, the Deccan Rights Commission was appointed to A, frame charges against those complicit in 1857 mutiny; B, revamp the police machinery to tackle increasing riots in the Deccan region; C, initiate proceedings against guilty zamindars for transacting Benami properties; D, investigate into the cause of Deccan uprising. So friends, the answer is D, that is to investigate the causes of Deccan uprising. So in 1875, there were Deccan riots. So they were basically targeted against the moneylenders of the Maharashtra region, Gujar moneylenders, and also there was much oppression. So first of all, the peasants boycotted these moneylenders, but later on this movement turned into a full-fledged uprising. So the Deccan Rights Commission was appointed by the government to investigate into the causes of Deccan uprising. So the solution is D. Let's move on to the last question of the day, the 10th question. The 10th question is, the Bhartoli Satyagraha of 1928 was a non-tax movement of peasants, B, anti-land leasing movement led by zamindars, C, reaction against commercialization of agriculture, D, frenzied outburst of tribals against land encroachment by the British. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you, friends, that the answer is A, a non-tax movement of peasants. So basically, during this time, there was famine as well as floods. So there was crop failure. So for this reason, peasants did not have that much of ability to pay the taxes. But in contrary to this situation, the Bombay Presidency government increased the taxes. So basically, it was a no tax movement under Sardar Patel. So this is termed as Bhartoli Satyagraha of 1928. So this is the answer would be A. So these are the questions of friends of today, friends. If you like these questions, if you like the video, then do hit a like, share it with your friends. And lastly, in case you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, you can email us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com. You can also contact us or contact at our contact number, that is 8968426481. So obviously there will be a minimum cost for the subscription of explanation PDFs, but it has been kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability as well as for the purpose of our motivation. So and lastly, friends, do ensure that you subscribe to our channel, and also do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications about the updates that we do on our channel. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice